Welcome back, students. In the previous video, we saw how we can analyze any PDF file and check whether they are having any malwares or not. In this video, we are going to analyze any image file, for example, any JPEG file, any M. In this video, we are going to analyze some image files, for example, JPEG, PNG, BMP, etc. So, what is the use? What is the need for analyzing image files? Now, sometimes it may happen that these image files that we capture from a particular evidence drive or from a particular crime scene, these may have a lot of information hidden inside them. If you remember, we had recovered some images using autopsy tool, right? So sometimes these images, which consist a lot of information, sometimes these images may have a lot of information hidden with. Sometimes these images may have a lot of hidden information present in them. For example, the metadata information. Now, what exactly is metadata? Well, practically speaking, metadata is all about data about data. That is, it is basically like a pointer which is pointing towards some other piece of data. So, it is like data which describes some other data. So, if we have metadata information with us derived from those images, they will definitely help us identifying a lot of crucial evidences from that particular image. For example, where was the image taken? What is the latitude, longitude of that image? What is the device which was used to capture that image? Was it a Samsung phone? Was it a Nokia phone? Was it any other phone? The device information also matters a lot. We can also come to know what was the megapixel count of that camera using which the image was taken, etc., etc. So these are all the metadata information which comes really handy whenever a particular investigation is carried out. So let's have a look what is this tool Imago all about and how we can make use of this tool to capture evidences from an image. So let's have a look at this tool Imago. What is it used for and how we can capture evidences from images using this tool? Well, this tool is a Python implementation and it is readily available on the internet. You can simply go to Google and search Imago tool, and the very first link will redirect you to this particular page. So how to run Imago? How to install Imago on your Kali machine? It's very simple. The very first thing that you need to do is you need to install Imago. As it's a Python executable, so we need to install it using pip. So we need to do it using pip install Imago. So it will take some time depending upon how many requirements you already have on your computer. As it's a Python executable, there are some files which are required. There are some libraries which are required. Let me go through these requirements. These must be installed on your machine before you are trying to install Imago. So by chance, if these requirements are not satisfied, kindly install them beforehand and then install Imago. So let's press enter, pip install Imago. Again, I would say that it will take some time depending whether the requirement is satisfied in your computer or not. In my case, as you can see, I already have all those libraries present in my computer. As you can see over here, there are some warnings also, but you can safely ignore those warnings and proceed ahead. So once all the requirements are satisfied, the next thing which you can do is simply enter Imago in your terminal and press enter. If it is installed successfully, you won't see any error. As a result, as you can see, Imago is installed successfully on your computer and there are no errors whatsoever. Now, before going into the practicals involving Imago tool, let me show you what exactly are we trying to find out. There is one file format of images called as EXIF. Now, what is EXIF? EXIF stands for Exchangeable Image File Format, which is nothing but a standard file format which captures a lot of information about that image. Where that image was taken, what was the device on which the image was captured upon, what was the time around which the image was clicked, and a lot of other information which revolves around that image. You can also get to know what was the device using which that particular image was clicked. Was it a camera, digital camera, DSLR camera, or was it a mobile phone? So all these informations can be captured using the EXIF metadata, and that is what we are
trying to find out in this particular experimentation session. So after some research, I found out a very beautiful website over here. As you can see, it is a GitHub repository, which is having a lot of images stored beforehand, which you can use for your experiment purpose. Over here, as you can see, there are different folders where different format images are stored. They are further segregated into multiple folders depending upon the actual data they consist of. For example, these are the images present over here, but I am interested in finding out the images which can tell me the exact latitude and longitude of a particular image. So for that, I would select this folder GPS. Let me select the first image. Let me go to download and save it on my machine. I already have this image stored on my machine, so I won't download it again. Now what I can do is I can go to the shared folder, which I actually share with my Kali Linux. As I have already discussed in our previous videos, that you need to have a shared folder, which will ultimately simplify your task of copying the data to the Kali machine and copying data from the Kali machine. So here is my shared folder. As you can see, it is inside that games and movies folder, Kali shared folder. I have already copied that image over here in the shared folder, so that I can easily access that from my Kali machine. So let me check. Yeah, it is the same image. Now let me go back to my Kali machine and copy this image from the shared folder. This is the shared folder, and let me check if this image is the same one. As you can see, this is the same image, and you will be able to make out that a lot of information is already depicted in the image properties, but still we want more information out of that image. For that, we will make use of this tool Imago. So let's get started. Copy this image on the desktop and then we can get started with our task. The very first thing that we need to do is we need to first of all check whether the options that we are going to use with Imago are correct or not. So the best thing to do with any new tool is hit the help menu, and as you can see, it has got a limited number of options, but very useful options. As we are going to make use of EXIF images, so I am interested in this minus X. Let me increase the font size just for better visibility. Okay, so right now I'm interested in the EXIF metadata, so I would be making use of this option minus X. Also, I am interested in finding out the GPS information, so I will be making use of minus G. So let's see how the command looks like. It is Imago space minus I stands for input, space the folder where your image is actually located. It's placed in the desktop, so I would simply type this much. So it doesn't matter how many images are present in that folder, whatever number of images are present inside that folder, all those images will be scanned and EXIF metadata will be extracted for those images. So I'm simply giving the root folder where that particular image is located, this one, space minus O. Minus O stands for the output directory. It is again in root, space desktop. Now, one thing to note over here, I already have one output file from any previous operation. Let me delete it just to avoid any overwriting. Fine. So it's clear now. Now I have to select the options that are, those are minus X and minus G. All set. Let me press enter. Now you can see extraction of metadata is taking place and it is already done. So that is what I was saying, that it is saved with a file name imago.csv. So that's why I deleted the previous file, just to avoid any issues. So the output is nothing but a CSV file in which the information extracted from the image are stored. So let me open this file imago.csv, and this is how the metadata looks like. Although it is not that readable using this format, so what we are going to do is we are going to see this file on my Windows machine, and then we will try to figure out what exactly is stored inside this particular file. So let me copy this file and place it in the shared folder over here. As you can see, I already have previous results, so let me delete those and paste it over here. So this is pasted. Now let me go back to my Windows machine and check this particular file using any of the CSV readers. And this is how the file looks like. Let me open this. And as you can see, this is looking much better than the previous version. Again, it is quite jumbled up, but we can rearrange the size of these columns and we will be able to at least gather some information out of this table. So let me just rearrange the size or resize these columns and you will be able to get a lot of information from this. Okay, fine. So this much is fine, I guess. Let me try. The first value is file name. This is the file name. Next is the versions, MIME. It is a JPG image format. Size is 161713, approximately this much bytes. Then the last modified time. Around this time, it was last modified, if you can see it now. Fine. So I'm just highlighting it over here. Last modification time. It is nothing but this one. That is right now, 1st of May 2021. Last access, it is going to remain the same, I guess. The time, that is again 1st of May 2021. This was the last access time. Creation time, parse, GPS, latitude. This is what we want. Yes, exactly. This is the latitude and longitude information that I actually wanted. And this is where it is present. Let me select this, latitude and longitude. Yeah, this one. Over here, as you can see, 43.467 and 11.885. This is what we are looking for. This is the latitude and longitude of that image. This is the place where that image was clicked, and then the rest of the informations, the location, also the GPS altitude, GPS satellites, a lot of information you can see is present over here. Fine, so let me quickly check the exact location where this image was clicked. For that, we need the latitude and longitude information that is present somewhere over here. Let me copy this 43.46. If you have carefully seen my previous videos, in one of those videos, I have already shown you how to check the latitude and longitude of a particular evidence or a particular image. For that, you simply need to go to Latitude Longitude Finder, and there is one website called Dougal or something like that. Yeah, dougal.co.uk. You can visit that website. It is one of the best websites I found. It shows the latitude longitude in a much easier, much user friendly way. So click on enter a latitude longitude, press paste those values, again go back and paste the value in a better way and click on go to this location. I guess this is clicked somewhere in Italy or somewhere near that. Yeah, you can see it is clicked in Arizona, and this is nothing but it is near Italy. So this is how useful the GPS timestamps, this is how useful the EXIF metadata is, because you will be in a position to crack down the location or the exact location where that particular image was clicked just by finding out the EXIF metadata from that image. Just imagine that you are investigating a traditional crime and somehow you got some evidences in the form of images and you would like to figure out where that particular image was clicked. In such a scenario, this particular device really comes very handy. So that's it. This is all about this tool called Imago. And if you have multiple images in a particular folder, then also this tool will work out, because what you are doing is you are not specifying the exact file name. You are specifying the folder where the images are present, and using that folder as the root folder, all the images present inside that folder will be scanned and the EXIF metadata information of those images will be extracted. So I hope you like this video. In the next video, we are going to learn about password cracking. Videos number 3 and 4 will be all about password cracking, where we are going to learn about the tools John the Ripper and Rainbow Tables. So stay tuned for the next videos on password cracking.